This is Jared Horak for today's RacingDigest.com. My today's Racing Digest video series continues Saturday, December 14th, 2019. We're going to jump over to Los Alamitos Racecourse. We're going to do the eighth race. It's the Soviet Problem Stakes for California bred two-year-old fillies, and they're going to be traveling 1 mile on the main track. Let's pull up the race header right now. And for today's Racing Digest, I've pulled up the race header multiple times. You'll see some information there. You'll see it at the top. It says eighth race, Los Alamitos. The distance is 1 mile. You'll see the track profile. There have been 28 races at this distance, 39% front runners, 39% stalkers. So those, you probably want to be at least somewhat forwardly placed. You'll see all the horses in the race. Warren's Moon is the inside horse. Smiling Shirley. You have California Kook. Jody Faster. You have Phoenix Tears. No Sherry Like My Sherry. Chula Lips. Been studying her. Warren Showtime, Almost a Factor. So that's the field here. I'm going to jump over the numbers I'm most interested in and the information I'm most interested in the race header. Go over to line 4 and 5. For line 4, you'll see RCL. The RCL is basically the class level that the horses have been performing at. And then you'll see line 5, the CPR. The CPR is the comprehensive performance rating, which takes into account pace, final time, and closing fraction. And then line 6, you'll see it says total. So you take line 4, the RCL, the class level, you add it to the CPR, the comprehensive performance rating, and then you get a total number. The higher number, the better. And been studying her, your morning line favorite, has a 247, and then Warren Showtime has a 244. 241, excuse me. So those are the two highest horses, combination of class with the CPR. Now we're going to look at the fast figs in this race. Now the fast figs, again, something we've used multiple times. It's a combination class rating, speed rating, all rolled into one number. And again, been studying her with a 116. That one has a 4-point edge over Smiling Shirley and Warren Showtime. They both have 112s. So those are the leading horses on numbers. And now we're going to go to my top four contenders in this race. And I'll begin with my fourth contender, the 2, Smiling Shirley. She's 9-2 morning line. She was no match for been studying her in her last couple, but she did run well, hitting the board both times, and her numbers are going in the right direction. Now, I think it's possible that she could move forward again. She's making her second start off of a layoff, her first start around 2 turns. That's going to be the key. If she can handle 2 turns, maybe she can close the gap on been studying her, who's also making her route debut. So Smiling Shirley looks like a decent threat. She drew well enough in here as well. My third choice will be the 9, Warren Showtime. We mentioned that one as having the second best number from the RCL and CPR, and then co-second best number in fast figs. So Warren Showtime, the key to this one is the distance should be to her liking. She has 2 victories at 1 mile, but both of those wins were on the turf course. And she's run twice on the main track. She finished 3rd both times. And in one of those 3rd-place finishes, that was against your favorite, been studying her, and Smiling Shirley last time. So she ended up finishing 3rd. That was okay. The distance is a definite benefit, and she should offer some value. Now, my second choice will be the 8, been studying her. She's 7-5 morning line. She's 3-4 in her career. Her lone loss, she finished 4th in the Grade 1 Chandelier against Bast. Bast came back last week and won a Grade 1 at Los Alamitos, the Grade 1 Starlet. Bast is a 3-time Grade 1 winner. So she was overmatched when she finished 4th that day. But all 3 of her wins were in sprints, 2 against Cowbred Company. So now she's in with Cowbred Company. The only question is going to be the distance here. If she handles the distance, she's got the best number. She's probably the one to beat. If she can't quite get the distance, maybe one of my other contenders can beat her. And my top choice in here, I'm going to go, it's not on the numbers here, just some different angles, but I'm going to go with the 3, California Kook, 6-1 morning line as my top choice. Now, second time out, she added blinkers, she switched to the main track, and she broke her maiden at this 1 mile distance on November 22nd at Del Mar. So that was a nice effort. Then that race, she didn't earn a strong number, but the pace was very slow. It was just a slow pace. She wasn't able to really uncork a big number because the pace was slow, but she looked good winning that one from off the pace. She won easily, and we know that the distance won't be any problem for her. Now, her older full sister, Kookie Gal, she won the 2018 Soviet Problem Stakes. for the same trainer, same owner, for Peter Miller, and the trainer of this one as well. A different rider this time, but the same owner and trainer had the winner of this race last year in the same sire, the same dam. So California Kook coming off that nice win at 1 mile. She's making her third start. Now, Kooky Gal last year was making her third start as well. So there's a lot of similarities between California Kook and last year's winner, Kooky Gal. And at 6-1, I'm thinking that, you know, I'll take my chances that she's maybe a little bit faster on paper than she appears. Now, here's how we're going to play this race. We're going to make a win wager on number 3, California Kook. We're going to play an exacta box with California Kook, number 3, and number 8, been studying her. And then we're going to play another exacta. We're going to put my three horses that I like other than the favorite on top of the favorite. So that will be the 2, Smiling Shirley, the 3, California Kook, and the 9, Warren Showtime on top of number 8, been studying her. And then a trifecta. We're going to put the 3 and 9 on top, California Kook and Warren Showtime, the 2 horses that are experienced at 1 mile and they're winners at this 1 mile distance. We're going to put those 2 on top of the other 2 contenders that I like in this race, the 2 Smiling Shirley, the 8 been studying her. So that trifecta is 3-9 with 2-3-8-9 with 2-3-8-9. So the wager's scrolling across the screen now, and hopefully we can get some of these wagering strategies home. There's a chance that we can hit multiple wagering strategies in this race, especially if California Kook gets the job done. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel, make some comments in the comment section. Who do you like in this Soviet Problem Stakes at Los Alamitos Racecourse? If you're interested in the complete digest from Los Al, you can find that at todaysracingdigest.com. And also, if you're interested, if you want the fast figs, you can get the fast figs for $3 for this complete card at todaysracingdigest.com as well. That will wrap up this week's video. My full cards will resume opening day at Santa Anita on December 26th. And I'll be back next week with another stakes race from around the country.